गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद अवर लेक्चर नंबर 6 और दिस इज द एक्चुअल टेलीग्राफर्स मॉडल ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन लाइन। सो वी हैव अ ट्रांसमिशन लाइन ए टू बी ए डैश बी डैश एंड फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज वी आर गोइंग टू डिवाइड अवर ट्रांसमिशन लाइन इंटू अ स्मॉल स्टेप्स ऑफ डेल्टा एक्स एंड सेकेंड स्टेप इज then we are going to assume that this delta x is tends to zero. So when we divide this into a small section of delta x, from our knowledge we know this small section of delta x can be modeled using a lump component. So we have inductance L and their unit with tens per meter, but when we multiply it by delta x, so L into delta x will give us inductance of this particular small section. Similarly, we will get resistance, capacitor, and conductance. Now we are assuming that we are applying voltage V and associate current is I. This we are applying at input AA dash and at output PP dash or at point PP dash, we are going to receive some voltage V plus delta V and some current I plus delta I. Now, as an electronics engineer, we know this V plus delta V is obviously going to be less than V, right? Because there are some voltage drop across inductor as well as resistor, right? Similarly, I plus delta S is going to be less than the I. Now, we will apply time domain KVL and KCL. So when I apply KVL, what we will get? Voltage at x minus t, so voltage at AA dash minus drop across this inductor, so that is nothing but L delta x multiplied by derivative of current minus drop, or we can say plus drop across R delta x minus R delta x resistance multiplied with this current I, and again the final voltage here V plus delta V. This is the expression for KVL. Now we apply KCL to this particular circuit. So now here we can observe on this entire line my current is I. So this current I x of t, so this, or we can say voltage which is stored in the capacitor, so that is C delta X multiplied by time difference of this particular voltage V plus delta V. Similarly, conductance minus C into delta X multiplied by this voltage V plus delta V, and minus this final current I plus delta I. Okay, so entire expression is KCL expression is current going inside at this particular junction, leaving here, leaving here, and leaving here. Okay. So what is the next step we supposed to do? We have to divide this expression by delta x and apply limit delta x tends to zero. Our expression will look like this. Limit delta x tends to zero. Then we will have, look here, this is V x comma t minus V x comma t plus delta V x comma t. So, and if that particular minus sign, if I put another side, we will get delta V x comma t is equal to minus L delta x day by day by t x of t minus r delta x x comma t, right? So this is just, I have applied limit and readjusted this. So when then I will divide by delta x. So when I do this, this expression will be like this, and this delta x will be removed. This delta x will be removed because it is like divided and cancelled out, right? So what will be the final expression? Deba v by deba x, where this voltage has some space and time, equals to L deba I x comma t by dt minus R into I x comma time divided by dt. This is one of the telegrapher's equation. Similarly, when you apply for KCL, you will get delta x tends to 0, delta I x comma t divided by delta x, which will be equal to deba I x comma t by deba x, which is equal to minus g voltage at x comma t minus c dv by dt. These two equations are called as telegrapher's equation. So now we will move on to electrical equations of voltage and current. So in this section, we represent our this small section as a lump element model. So now if you see the difference between this one and the previous one, here you can see your capacitor and the conductor is now shifted from right hand side to the left hand side. So this is the another lump element model we are using. So we have to use the model as per, we have to select the model such a way that our analysis is become simpler and simpler. Okay, so now let us assume that the input frequency is f and angular frequency is w, which is applied at a dash, and current I flows into this terminal. So there will be some voltage drop across this R and L circuit, and similarly there will be some voltage at PP dash, and that voltage is V plus delta V. Again, from our knowledge we know this V plus delta V is going to be less than V. Okay, similarly current I flows through this circuit, and at PP dash we are receiving current I plus delta I, and again from the knowledge we know I plus delta I is going to be less than the I. So now we will write down the expression for delta V and delta I. So expression for delta V is nothing but path loss, we can say a voltage drop across R and L, right? So it is series. You can write R delta X, that is nothing but your resistance, plus J omega L delta X, that is nothing but your inductance, multiplied by current I. So this is the voltage dropped across R and L. Okay, and this expression we will named it as a one, expression number one. We will write second expression, that is my delta I minus G dot X, that is conductance, plus J omega C delta X, the voltage V. Now if you look here carefully, you will find a negative sign, and this negative sign indicates that this voltage and current at PP dash are less than the respective AA dash. So this can be rewritten as delta V divided by delta X R plus J omega L times current. And similarly for delta I by delta X, it will be negative G plus J omega C times voltage. This is my equation number three. So as we discussed earlier, if the lumped analysis has to be valid at all the frequency, okay, this is not valid for all the frequency, right? Because we can see this term delta X. If you want to make sure that it is valid for all the frequency, the length of this section, that is delta X, must tend to zero. So now we have to take the limit delta X tends to zero for above two equations. What we will get? Limit delta X tends to zero delta V by delta X is equal to So by definition, it is nothing but a derivative dv by di, which is equal to minus r plus j omega l times I. This is my equation number 5. This is my equation number 6. This is my equation number 5. This is my equation number 6. If you look this very closely, this is nothing but my differential equation of voltage and current. So in low frequency analysis, my voltage and current are related to each other using some linear function, that is V is equal to IR, right? But now at high frequency, we have to deal with a first order or second order differential equation. So now we are able to see the derivative of voltage, input applied voltage with respect to space, or we can say length or section, is depends upon the current. Similarly, differentiation of current with respect to space is depends upon the voltage. So these two equations depends upon each other. That's why we name these two equations as first order coupled first order differential equations. So name of these two equations are coupled first order differential equations. So these are the coupled equations. Now we are going to decouple these equations and find out the actual expression. So now how we are going to decouple the equation number 5? If we differentiate this equation with respect to x one more time. Okay, what do we mean by decoupling? If you look here, there are two parameters. One parameter is voltage, another parameter is current. Now when we say we want to decouple this, it means that there should be only one parameter in one equation. It means here we need some expression with respect to V. Here also we need some expression with respect to I. So once we do that, we say we have decoupled this equation. If I derivate this equation number 5 with respect to x, then here I will get di by dx. And di by dx expression is present over here. So my this entire equation will be with respect to V. So when we do that, we will get d2V by dx square equal to minus, this is constant, di by dx. Substitute this equation number 6 above in equation 7. So now we will have d2V by dx square is equal to minus r plus j omega l in multiplication minus g plus j omega c times v. So it is nothing but r plus j omega l g plus j omega c times v, and this is my expression number 8. Similarly, when I decouple equation number 6, it will be d2i by dx square equal to minus g plus j omega c into dv by dx. So we will get an expression d2i by dx square is g plus j omega c times r plus j omega l into I. Now observe equation 8 and 9. If we compare my voltage equation 8 with 9, I can able to locate that proportionality constant is one and the same. Now we will name this constant as gamma. Gamma is propagation constant of this transmission line. गामा इज नॉट इक्वल टू दिस, बट गामा स्क्वेर इज इक्वल टू आर प्लस जे ओमेगा एल इंटू जी प्लस जे ओमेगा सी. गामा इज प्रोपोगेशन कॉन्स्टेंट एंड गामा स्क्वेर इज दिस मल्टीप्लीकेशन. सो इफ दिस इज माई इक्वेशन नंबर 10, सो वी हैव डिफाइंड propagation constant and that name is gamma. Gamma square is nothing but r plus j omega l g plus j omega c. One thing is very clear that gamma is some characteristic parameter. So gamma depends upon all primary constant. Apart from this, it also depends upon the operating frequency. Omega is nothing but 2 pi f. So with the introduction of this gamma, we are going to get many more interesting result. Since this frequency, operating frequency is constant, this gamma is constant. So we will have a solution of second order differential equation S. For first equation number 11, it will be like V is equal to V plus e raised to minus gamma x plus V minus e raised to plus gamma x. Okay, so this is my equation number 13. Where this V plus and V minus are constant. This is my differential equation. Every differential equation has a unique solution. So this has this solution. Similarly, for current, I is equal to I plus e raised to minus gamma x plus I minus e raised to minus gamma. Okay, and this is equation number 14. So where this V plus V minus I plus I minus are arbitrary constant, which are to be evaluated by using some boundary conditions. And this constant in general are complex in nature. This V plus V minus. Let me again start from the beginning. First, we have identified value of delta V and delta I. We have made it independent of this delta x length, okay, and we got these expressions 5 and 6. Once, and this equation is free from the length, so since it is free from length, we can use it for any arbitrary frequency. Equation number 5 and 6, these equations are called as coupled first order differential equations, because now here two parameters are coupled. Derivative of voltage depends upon the current, derivative of current depends upon the voltage, and this derivative is with respect to space. So then we have decoupled this equation and we have identified the true nature. So we reduce our expression over here. We are assuming that this gamma square is constant. This gamma square is constant. What is this gamma square? R plus j omega l into g plus j omega c. To provide a solution, you will get this as a solution, unique solution, where this gamma square is constant, which will come e raised to power this gamma, and this parameter will come over here. If I ask you derive telegrapher equation, steps will be you have to define KVL KCL in time domain. Divide by delta x, apply limit delta x tends to 0, and you will get this expression. When I say derive coupled equation, these are nothing but your coupled equation. Since voltage depends upon the current, so differentiation of current with respect to space depends upon the voltage, hence they are called as coupled equation of transmission lines. Okay, if I say provide solution for coupled equation, you need one equation, one parameter, one equation, one parameter. So you, again, it is simple that how you are going to remove this I. We don't have any expression for I, but we do have expression for di by dx. So it simply means you need to differentiate this equation, substitute this value over here. Okay, so there will be a term di by d. When you differentiate this equation, you will have one term di by dx, substitute this expression over here. And then this equation will be free from I. So there will be only parameter v. Okay, so when I say provide a solution, you are going to write up to equation number 14. And for today's class, I think this much is enough. Thank you everyone for patience listening. Now, if you have any doubt, you can always approach me on WhatsApp as well as on email. If you are encountering error, reaching out to quizzes or our assignment or the material which we are publishing time to time on Google Meet as well as Google Classroom. So you are welcome to fill up that error form as well. Okay, thank you everyone. Thank you.